Hello and welcome. In this video, we will cover Boolean logic, if statements, sorting and filtering data, and lookup functions in Excel. In mathematics, we can often compare numbers to determine if a specific relationship exists. For example, is one number larger than another? We can then evaluate whether or not that statement is true or false. Here, we are evaluating the relationships between values for A and B. In Excel, the operator for these comparisons are similar to the mathematical operators. Note that the operators for greater than or equal to and less than or equal to are composed of two characters, as is the operator for not equal. Excel can compare more than just numerical data. Here, we compare dates and text. When comparing text, note that numbers come before letters. In addition, text comparisons are case insensitive. Dog with a lowercase d is equal to dog with an uppercase d. If we want the comparison to be sensitive to case, we use the exact function. When comparing text, we sometimes want to compare only part of the text. This is often the case when comparing alphanumeric codes. In such situations, we can use the following text functions to isolate characters from the left, right, or middle of text. When using the mid function, we specify the start position and the number of characters we want. The position of the first leftmost character is 1. And increases by 1 as we move to the right. In addition, we could convert all the characters to upper or lowercase. Let's get back to our comparisons. For each one, the result is either true or false. This is the basis for Boolean logic. In Boolean logic, a statement can evaluate to true or false. There is no other value. This is analogous to a binary digit, which is either 1, true, or 0, false. In Boolean logic, statements can also be combined with operators to form more complex statements. These operators are not, and or, and they have equivalent Excel functions. The not function takes a Boolean statement and inverts it. It turns true to false and false to true. The and function evaluates to true if and only if all of its arguments evaluate to true. Essentially, it asks, are all these statements true? The OR function evaluates to true if and only if at least one of its arguments evaluates to true. Essentially, it asks, is one of these statements true? One of the benefits of computers is their ability to seemingly make decisions. What they actually do is evaluate a Boolean condition. The computer then follows one set of instructions if the result is true, and a different set of instructions if the result is false. We can model the same branching in Excel using the if function. Here, we write a formula to test if these students have passing or failing grades. If the mark is greater than or equal to 50, they pass. Otherwise, they fail. We can even nest if statements in one another. If a condition is met, we have our answer. If not, we test another condition, and so on. Once we test for a grade of 40, we know the letter grade. If it's 40 or greater, it's an E. Otherwise, it's an F. There is no need for further if statements. As an aside here, we can filter out and display only those students with a specific grade. To do that, click on the Grade heading and select the Filter icon from the Home tab on the ribbon. From the drop-down menu, you can select only those grades you want to see. When finished, you can simply toggle off the Filter icon. To To sort your results, you select your data and select Custom Sort. Here, make sure My Data Has Headers is enabled. Select which column you want to sort and in which direction, large to small or small to large. You can also add additional levels of sorting. Each level adds a criterion by which to sort the results that are equal from the previous level. Let's get back to the if statement. The functionality of the if statement is sometimes combined with other functions. The COUNTIF function counts the number of cells that satisfy a Boolean condition. The SUMIF function sums the cells that satisfy a Boolean condition. In both cases, the Boolean condition must be in quotes. When we calculated the letter grades, there were a lot of nested if statements, even more if we had included A+, B+, etc. When you have a large number of comparisons, using the lookup function is more convenient. It looks up a value in one lookup column and returns the corresponding value in a second result column. This would allow you to look up the numeric mark in one column and return a letter grade from the next column. There are two requirements for the lookup column. 1. The values must represent the lower bound of the grade, for example, 80 for an A, 70 for a B, etc. And 2. It must be sorted with the smallest value at the top. The VLOOKUP function adds some flexibility to the lookup function. Instead of specifying only two columns, we can specify a two-dimensional range, a matrix of values. VLOOKUP still searches the first leftmost column, but it does not have to be sorted. With VLOOKUP, we specify the column number that contains the result. This could be a fixed, static number, or the result of another calculation. Lastly, we have the option of searching for an exact match only, indicated by the argument false, or an approximate match, indicated by an argument of true, if an exact match isn't found. For an approximate match, VLOOKUP returns the closest, smaller value, just like the lookup function. The lookup function works on either columns or rows, but VLOOKUP only works for columns. The V stands for vertical. If you want the same functionality in horizontal rows, use HLOOKUP. But what if you want more flexibility? Excel offers functions called match and index, and they're often used together. Let's look at the schedule as an example. The match function searches for a given value in a column or range and returns the position of a match. The match can be exact, indicated by an argument of 0, the closest value less than, indicated by an argument of -1, or the closest value greater than, indicated by an argument of 1. Suppose a user provides us with a day and time. We can use match to search for the location of the given day within the row of days. We can also use match to search for the location of the given time in the column of time. Now we have the corresponding row and column within the schedule, essentially the coordinates of the value we need to return. The index function takes a two-dimensional range, a row number, and a column number, and returns the value at that row and column location within the range. Now, if we wanted to, we could combine the match and index functions into one formula. In this example, we could also use match and VLOOKUP, but using match and index is more flexible. Remember, VLOOKUP can only look up values in the leftmost column. Match can search any range you specify. These lookup functions are very useful in searching and retrieving values from large sources of data. Thanks for watching.